Hi all, so welcome to this channel, and today I am presenting this topic, and that is QM query in ES400. So I'll be discussing about this in detail, and sure we can execute dynamic SQL queries using this QM query feature in CL programming. So I'll be discussing all these points which I mentioned here, like create QM query, start QM query, what is QM query object, what is QM form object, what is query definition, set variable, and all these cases I'll be discussing with you, these examples as well. So it will be actually whole detailing of the QM query in ES400. So this whole video will cover all these points. So after this video, I think you will have some understanding of the QM query, and you will be able to create your own QM query objects using query definitions, QM query form, or whatever you want to do. So let's start with the beginning. So first thing is, what is QM query object in ES400? So it's basically whenever we create a source whose source type is, source member type is QM query, and object type is star QM query, that is a QM query object. QM query is basically query management object. So here I would say that I would be executing the dynamic SQL statements. However, if you look into the run SQL statement command, there you can execute a set of SQL statements which are written in some source member, and that is not dynamic, that is you cannot pass parameters to them. So you have to execute some sort of SQL which is already written. But here in QM query, you can execute a dynamic SQL, you can pass the parameters, you can pass the whole statement as well at the runtime. So that's the power of this QM query in ES400. So I would say that but the drawback here for this is, you can only execute only one SQL statement at a time. So you can write multiple statements in QM query, and you can create that query, but you won't be able to start that, you won't be able to run that QM query if you have written multiple SQL queries in that. So only one SQL is allowed, one SQL statement allowed per QM query source and object. So let's talk about the SQL statement. So I would say mixed case is not allowed there. So if you are writing it that in the small case, that would always be converted to the uppercase. So I would say uppercase is always allowed. So in case if you are writing mixed case, that would cause issue. Now there is an important thing, that is the source physical file of QM query source. So whenever you are creating the source physical file, for that must be of 91 length. If that is greater than that, like 92, that is for CL or RPG, QRPG SRC, or for DDS source. So in that case, you will be getting errors, or you will be getting the warning that the source physical file is exceeding the length 91. So whenever you are creating the QM query source, the source physical file length must be 91. So that consists of six length line number, six length date, and the rest one, that is 79 length, would be of data. Now, and as I already said, one SQL statement is allowed, and that may be dynamic, might be dynamic. Now let's move on to the QM query objects. Let's create the first QM query object here. So here I created some sources, so I'll be letting you know one by one each and everything. so I'll be picking the first one. So that's let's first delete all the objects, if any resides. So these are all the objects, I would delete them. So this is the first QM query source, that is select star from this. So here you can see all are in uppercase and there is no semicolon at the end. That there is no semicolon required. In case if you'll write that, you won't be able to execute that. That would be an error. So let's see. This was the SQL statement which you written in this QM query source. Select a star from QNA40. You can only write one SQL statement. Now let's create the first QM query. So you can create the QM query using command create QM query. Just take F4 here. So you will be prompted with these parameters. So first thing you need to mention here is the QM query name, object name. So I would suggest that the object and the source name must be same. You may take them as different. You may write QM query 1A or something else. I would write the same. So whatever the source member name is, I would be picking that one as well, that one only for the object name. Now here the source physical file name. Source physical file name is QM query src in my case. Here you will be mentioning the library. Here also you'll be mentioning the library, but here I am picking the current library in both the cases. And if here you can see star label, which is in my current library, is in my library list, so it could be picked automatically. Now here you need to mention the source member. So the source member is QM query 1. Here you may mention the text for that QM query. I'm not mentioning that right now. Just take F10. Nothing else. So press enter. So you need to only mention the object name, the source member, where it is present, its location, and that's all. Just press enter and your object is created. Work object QM query 1. So you can see your object QM query 1 is created. That's of type star QM query and its attribute is SQL. Now you have your QM query object. How would you gonna run this? So for that purpose we have a command strqm query. Just take F4 here. So just take F10 again. Now here you need to mention the query QM query object name, QM query 1. Now you will be seeing two parameters like output star. So if you mention star here, just take F4, star print or star output. So all these are supported, that is you can display the result, you can print the result, you can take the result in the out file. So I'm currently displaying the result, and here it is QM form. QM form is basically a query management form which is just used to show the report layout. So for example, if your query fetches a table record, like select star from some table, and your table has four records and your column names are like field 1, field 2, field 3, field 4, and all those values are fetching, so you can give your own report layout that how your data would be printed or looking after the execution of QM query. So I'll be letting it you know. And for QM query forms, like how we will be creating these QM query forms, I'll be creating a separate video for that, because that again a separate topic, that how we can create a QM query form from the scratch. So but I'll be letting you know what QM query form is, what it's all about, how we can have the object of this. So I'll be letting you know. Just focus on the first thing here right now, that is QM query object. So here we have QM query 1, which is in my library list, and just I am displaying the output. Just press enter. So you can see this is the default stake F4 10. So you can say system default layout is preferred. So system default layout is like this: student ID, student name, student age, student class. This was the data which is fetched from MySQL, but this is now, you can see this, how this looks. So this is basically a report layout, and this is end of data. So this was the actual data which was fetched from the SQL, but the column names you can see, and the underlines are there. So these are report layout thing, which is system defined. So you can see the result of this QM query 1. Now, as I said, display the output of QM query, print the output of QM query, save the output of QM query in out file. So let me show you that as well. Just print it, work job 4. So this is the file, qpqxprtf gets printed. So you can see report layout here. So this is the report layout, as you can see. Now if I use out file as output, so I can have the output in some file. So I have taken that in qtemp. Just see the output. That is A1. So this is the actual data which is fetched, and this was the layout which you can see, report layout, after executing the QM query. Now I have covered display the output of QM query, print the output of QM query, save the output of QM query in *out file. Now I'll be discussing about all these things later in this video, but I'll be discussing about them surely. Now move on to the scenarios. So first thing is run a static QM query from command line. So you can see I have executed the static QM query. So this is static, select star from QNA40, and let me run another static QM query. This one was the static one, select star from this, where student ID equals to A. So this will pick the record which has student ID equals to A. So let me create this, create QM query, that is QM query 5, QM query SRC, QM query 5. Just do work object QM query 5. You can see the object gets created. Just do str QM query, QM query 5. Just see the result. There you can see the report layout like this. So you will be getting only one record now, and which is now how displayed, how the report is displayed for that. So this was the example where I am running the static QM query from command line. Now you can run this from the CL program as well. You can write the same str QM query from the CL program, and you can execute that. You can print that, you can take them in the out file or so on. So you can do those things, or you can perform those things at your end for your practice. Now substitution variable run from command line. Let me show you the another scenario. So I am showing you all those scenarios which are possible. So This is the substitution variable, example QM query 3. So here you can see I have mentioned an variable which is prefix with and. So basically the variable is stmt, not and stmt, but this is prefix with and, just same as in case of CL programming we use. So I just use this state, this substitution variable, nothing else. There is no SQL command, no SQL statement written inside this QM query or source. So how would I gonna be execute this? So let's first create this. So for creating this, create QM query, QM query 3, QM query source, QM query 3, work object QM query 3. You can see the object. Now you need to run this. Now there are two ways to it. Just do str QM query, because you simply mentioned an substitution variable, you didn't mention the SQL statement. Just do strqm query, strqm query, and mention qm query 3. Just press enter once more. So once you press enter, you will be seeing a prompt takes place in front of you, and which asked that type a value for variable statement and press enter. Now you need to type a variable, this value for this variable, and press enter. So how we would be doing that? So I can write any SQL statement here. Just for example, select star from QNA 40 where stuid is not equal to a. So you can see I am getting the QM query report now. Again, if you gonna do this, it will again ask for the same, select star from QNA 40 where stuid equals to a. So you will be seeing the report again. Now for example, you do not want to give the value during the prompt. Let's give the value before running that query. So here if you take F10, you will be seeing more parameters. Just page down, you will be seeing this set var. So I'm talking about this set var. So here I will be mentioning stmt. So the actual variable is stmt, not and stmt. If I mention and here, I would be not allowed to write that. So stmt, here I need to provide the value. So value is basically an SQL statement, so that is not a value. Just for example, you are giving a value, select star from this table where student name equals to this. So equals student name equals to this, so that is a value, not a statement. That's a value actually. So here you are providing the statement. So what statement you wanna execute? So here I would be writing the value inside this single quote. Select stuid from QNA 40. So I am selecting only stuid right now. So you can see only stuid is printed and displayed to me using the QM query object. So you can see in both the way, I can provide the substitution variable value before executing that, or I can provide that using setvar, or I can provide that after executing that, and the prompt will be in before me and I can provide that value. So the same way, this was a very simple substitution variable. Now I'll be showing you some other substitution variable example, which is something different and having more substitution variables. Let me show you. So you can see here I mentioned four substitution variables. So you can take any number of substitution variable in your QM query. So you can see AND statement, AND where AND is to ID and ID value. Let me note it down in some notepad like this. Now first thing is to create this QM query. Create QM query object, QM query for QM query src, QM query for, just press enter. Just do work object QM query for. So you will be seeing that QM query for object is created. Just do str QM query. So the first thing is that you will pressing just mention, oh sorry, QM query 4. So you will be pressing enter. You will be asking for the substitution variable values and then pressing enter. So the statement would be like, for example, I want to write select star from QNA 40 in the first variable. So I would be providing select star from this, pressing enter. And where clause, I would be providing where. So let's write where here and press enter. In these two ID clause, where is to ID, so I would be providing to ID. So basically to ID is a variable, so I'm providing the value as to ID. And for the ID value, I would be providing, I think this was wrong. Let me take F3 here. Just I'm doing it again because I need to provide equals to as well. So let me provide the values again. Select star from QNA40 where, and here I am providing stuid equals to, and equals to I would be providing value as a. So you can see, so the value here would be providing with the single quotes, right? Because this is a value, not the statement. So in case if you are not giving a state single quote there, you will be getting error. So you can see the result here. Now if you want to execute this and want to provide the value substitution values using the set var, how you can do that? Let me show you that as well. So the first variable is and stmt, means stmt statement is, so I need to provide the value in single quote for this. The two plus for where, I need to provide the value as where. For the third substitution variable is to ID, I need to provide the value like is to ID equals to, for the fourth one ID value, I need to provide this A. Now I'm always providing the value within single quotes, okay, but this time I'm providing actual value of a field, so that has to be in the single character. But whenever we providing the values in single quotes, that always be in double quotes. So the double quotes is basically treated with the single quotes. So I'm giving like B here right now. So you can see this is the value in single quotes and provided within the single quotes. So single quote is written with the double quotes. Now just press enter. You will see the result. Okay, so you can change here accordingly. For example, A. So you'll be seeing the data A. Just take F10. You want to give not equal to A. So I'll be seeing all the results here. So yes, you can execute the substitution variable QM query, where QM query consists of the substitution variable. Only, and then you can execute them as well. So this is actually a dynamic. So this feature makes you like providing the parameters and execute your SQL query every time. So you can actually run your SQL queries, any SQL query on any table, using such QM query objects. So you don't need to execute a single, you don't need to write a query every time. So you can create your own query at the runtime. You can provide the values at the runtime. You can create your value. So you can do, you can achieve anything using this. But the only thing is you need to execute one SQL statement at a time. Now let's move on to the next thing. Run a static QM query. This is complete. Substitution variable is complete. Provide field name and values differently. So I showed you how I would be providing the field name in single quotes and values differently, that I have to provide the double quote for a single quote there. So this is done. Run SQL statement other than select. So let me show you this. This is the example for that. Just I'm creating a table in qtem/pf1 as select star from this with no data. So this is the just create a QM query object for this. QM query 7. Work object QM query 7. So that is created. Just run this. First check whether PF1 is there. No, PF1 is not there. STR QM query. QM query 7. So this is this that. Execution of that SQL statement is complete. You are not seeing any result because this is not a select statement. So just do work obj qtem/star all. So you will be seeing the file, or do display lib on qtem, you will be seeing pf1. Just check whether data is there or not, because you created with the no data. Yes, there is no data at all. So we are able to execute any statement from this. So this is also complete. I'll be letting you know this one and these things. Displaying query output, this is complete. Taking information, this is not complete. This I have to present, still present. Printing query output, that is done. Sending output to an existing file, this is done. This is what I have written here. Sending output, running a query containing substitution variable, this is also done. That is what I explained in this one. Changing a variable, let me show you that as well. So this was the QM query 6 object. Let me show you this. Select star from QNF40 VS2 ID equals to and ID well. So you can see here I use some static SQL and then I use the substitution variable. So that substitution variable is basically a value. is to id equals to a equals to b equals to something, I can provide that value. So how I would be changing that, let me show you. First I need to create a QM query. QM query 6 work object QM query 6. So this object is created. Just run this str QM query 6. Just press enter. You will be asking to provide the value here. So you would always be prompt, whenever this prompt happened, you would be providing that value in single quotes A. So you are seeing the result. You can provide that result, that value. You can change that value using, so that is actually ID value, and you can provide that in single quotes. So here we always provide in single quote, but anything we provide in single quote, but here we are providing value in single quote again. So that for that single quote, we will write two single quotes and then A, then double quote in this one. Okay. What is the ID val? Okay, I didn't provide the correct value. So the substitution variable name is ID val. That's why it went for the prompting again. So you can see the result. So if I change it to the B, you'll see the result again. So this is how we will be changing a variable or value. So this is covered, this is covered, this, these are also covered. Example 2 is left, which I will be letting you know. Let me show you this retrieve query first, retrieve QM query first. So for example, if you have any QM query object and you want to retrieve the source of that, so just for example, this is QM query 1, you have this source available, but just suppose this was deleted somehow and you have the object work object QM query 1. Now you can retrieve the source using this QM query. Retrieve QM query command is used for this. Just take F4. You need to mention QM query 1, that object name, and you need to mention here in which source file and in which source member you want to copy the QM query object source. So for example, right now I'm QM query src, I'm using the same source file, and I would be giving member QM query 1a for example. So let's see F5. So you can see QM query 1a is created with the same text, but here the type would be blank. You can see this was retrieved. This was the text which I written. Select a star from QNF40. So this is for the QM query 1. Let's see for the QM query 4. QM query 4, which has all the substitution variable. I'm taking that in 4A. So you will be seeing all the substitution variables. Let me show you this thing. So you are seeing that allow query definition star no star yes thing. So I'll be letting you know soon, because this is also a parameter which can affect this. So I'll be letting you know here. So all these things are completed right now. Query definition thing is left, and query form, QM query form. So QM query is complete now. But I have to mention QM query definition objects as well, because they are basically used. Query definition objects are used to create the QM query objects. So let me tell you how they are actually used. So first thing you need to do is to create the query definition object. So you can use work query command for that. Just press enter, take option 1 to create. Here you need to mention the query name, query 1. Suppose I want to create a query, query 1. Specify file selections, just take file is for example QNA40, the same example. Press enter. So you have selected the file, you can see this arrow. So you, now I want to select the sequence fields. So for example, this is the sequence. I want to have these things only. So you can see the arrow here. So you have select the sequence. Now I want to select the records. Let's take one here and stu id not equal to A. You want a sort field? No. Collating sequence? No. See, specify report column formatting. So this was the thing which I want to show you here. I would be taking the same thing to show you the QM form, because I would create a separate video to create a QM form using from the scratch, because that's a something which is which I need to tell you, and that's a typical thing for you to understand, and that's much more of like, so just take one here. So you can specify this thing, column spacing, length, decimal digit, edit. So whatever, suppose I want to change the column heading only. So in place of stu id, I want that report should show student id, student name. So the five fields are this, but the report would be look like something student age. So I have specified the report column formatting. I can select the report summary functions, but I'm not selecting that. Report breaks, no. Output type and output form, let's take one here. So output type is I want to take display. I don't want to print them on to database file, just take F12 from here and all these things. Just press enter and F3 to save this. So query 1 gets created. This would be the result, and this is the formatting, report layout formatting, which I did. So basically QM form, QM query is a way to run the dynamic SQL thing, and QM form is basically a way to display the layout or the report, as you can see the printer files. So this was just to define the report layout. So currently we are using the system defined QM form. Now here you can see, using the query definition, work query, we can define our own layout. So the field name was stu id, but here I am showing the student id. Field name was a student name, I'm student is to name, I'm showing student name. This was to age, I'm showing student age. Just save them, just to work object query 1. So you can see a query definition object gets created of name query 1 and whose attribute is query. So I'm discussing this one, query definition object. So using this query definition object, use query definition object to make QM query type object. So basically you can create a QM query object using this query definition. So for this thing, you are not writing any QM query object, QM query source right now. Like this, you have written a QM query source here, but now you are not writing any QM query source. So you have that QM query you have that query definition object, right? So what you can do is retrieve QM query. That's what I showed you. So for retrieving a QM query source, you can simply use this. For example, I am using the same name, query one, source file QM query src, source member query one. Now here you are seeing allow query definition object, which is Tanu. So if we have a QM query object present of name query one, then it would be picked from that, source would be retrieved from that. But here you can see we don't have query one as in QM query object, but we have an query one object of type query definition. So here it is asking allow information from query definition. So are we gonna allowing this command to retrieve the source from the query definition for a QM query? So because we are not gonna writing the source for the QM query right now, we are creating a QM query, we are creating the QM query source using the query definition. That's what the purpose here is. We are defining a QM query definition object and we are basically creating a QM query based upon this query definition. So I am mentioning this as star yes. Now do work object query one. So you can see that we don't have QM query type object, we have query definition type object. That's why we mentioned allow query definition star yes. So in case, so what happened in this case, first it checks for query one object as a QM query object, a star QM query object. So if that does not be find in that library list, then operating system goes and checks for the query definition object based upon this parameter if it is yes. And if that query definition object found, then the source will be retrieved from that query definition instead of QM query object. So let me show you the source which is retrieved, take F5. So you can see that source is retrieved query one. So this was the source, select all stu IDs, stu names, stu age from this, where stu ID is not equal to A. So basically this source was retrieved from the query definition object. Now we can create a QM query over this query one, QM query src query one. So just press enter. Now if you do QM work object query one, you will be seeing two objects because I created a QM query object using the same query definition object, and that QM query is of attribute SQL and type QM query. Now you have seen this demo that how I am gonna creating the QM query object using the query definition object. So yes, we can simply create a QM query object and we can create that object using the query definition as well. So that's what I'm explaining this one right now, or this example, taking information from either QM query or query definition. So first thing will be searched is QM query. If that is not found in the library list, then query definition object would be looked upon by the operating system, and that then the source would be fetched from that. Now QM query is created, just do str QM query over this query one, str QM query, just take F4, query one. You will be seeing the result. Now one important thing, if you do run query star n on that query definition query one, sorry, Wait. Just do work query. This will display query one from here. Just see the layout from here. You have specified the layout like this. Just change this something. Fine. Just take F5 here. So you would be seeing the layout like this. So you was seeing the layout like this for the query definition object. But when you are doing the QM query, you are not seeing that, because you are basically creating the QM query based upon the source, which is retrieved from the query definition object. So you didn't specify any layout for this. So for specifying the layouts, we have something QM query form objects, that is query management forms, which here I already, you can see here, I have already a ticket for that to create a QM query form from the scratch in ASP.NET. So I'll create I'll create a video on that. For now, let me show you something, whether I can show you that QM query form thing. So we have these command for the same create QM form. So we can create a QM form, and here we need to specify the query source file and source member where we have created that source form, and then we can create a form. So whenever we are actually starting the QM query, take F4, we can specify the QM form. So for this query, the report layout would be looked upon by this QM form, we can mention here. And we have retrieve query form command like this, retrieve query form. So I'm not creating the QM form right now, I'll be creating a separate video for that. Let's retrieve a QM form from the, we have this command can also be retrieved from the query definition object. So let's retrieve from this. So let's give the QM form name as one in the same library, and this would be a QM form, and source file would be the same QM query src QM form one. Allow query definition, yes. But here the QM form, this is wrong. Just let me tell you why, because here I need to mention the query name, query one. So I just mentioned the wrong thing, just to show you why it caused it, because that was not an object. So the same way, first it checks the QM form object, whether that query one is exist as a QM form object, and if this parameter is star yes, then it would then check for the query definition object, whether that is present with the same name, and if it is present, then the QM form would be retrieved using that. Just press enter. Retrieve QM form command completed using derived information. So you can see work object QM form one. You won't be seeing the QM form till now, because you have not created the object. Just do work member PDM. So you have retrieved the source basically. That's what I'm showing you, that so you can see this QM form. So for this only I would be telling you how we can do this in the later video. So you can see this various sections like h header, t is table, and r is for row and e for end, v for value, and like this all the things we will be providing in the Qn form. I'll be letting you know later, since this is something tough for you to understand right now. As I can show you, these would be the values which will be shown, and these would be the row. Three row would be there. And at last we would be mentioning the end. So this is the QM form which is created right now. So you can see that the report layout is changed. Student ID. Let me change this. Something changed. Changed. File. Now we can create a QM form. Create QM form using this QM form 1, which we retrieved in the QM query src source file. In QM form 1 was a source member, jkf10, nothing else. Now if you do QM form 1, so you can see QM form 1 type query form gets created. Now let me show you. Just do the strqm query again on query 1. So you are seeing stu id, student name, stu name and stu age right now, because you didn't use the report layout, that is a QM form. Now take f4 for the same thing. I'm not using the system default right now. I'm using the QM form 1, which is retrieved using the query definition. Now just see. Student ID changed, student name changed, student age changed. So you can see that how the layout gets changed now. So basically this was what this was actually QM form working is. So now I would be able to show you this QM query object form, query management form of form, how it works with the QM query and query definition things. So I think that's all, and that would be a good stuff for a QM query thing in S400 for someone who don't have any idea about this. So now he may perform the hands-on on this and may have a perfection on this. So one thing is left in this one, that is creating a QM form from the scratch. So how we can write the source from the scratch, this one, that is how I showed you how we can write the QM query, how we can create the query definition, how we can retrieve the source of QM query, query definition, how we can retrieve the QM form as well. All those things I have shown you. So the only thing left is to create a QM form from the scratch. But I already showed you that QM form can be retrieved using the retrieve QM form command, and can be retrieved from the query definition object. So, and even the QM query can be retrieved from the query definition object. So that's what I think in this video, and I hope you find this video useful for you. Thank you and have a nice time.